What is up, Neophytes? My name's Alan, aka NeoCryptor, and welcome to my first impressions of Last Oasis. If you're unaware, Last Oasis is a new survival MMO that comes out on Thursday, March 26th. I got early access to the early access and was able to jump in and play for a bit. And I thought I'd share my impressions with you. First off, let's read the description of the game a little bit for you guys. So, Last Oasis is a nomadic survival MMO. Earth has stopped rotating, and the last human survivors need to outrun the scorching sun in a massive open world. And they're not kidding on that part, but we'll talk more about that in a minute. Independent developers Donkey Crew announced today that their post-apocalyptic clan-based nomadic survival MMO, my god, is that a mouthful, Last Oasis will be entering early access soon. With a strong focus on global economy and clan-based territorial control, Last Oasis is full of elements and mechanics from various genres intertwined to form an organic and cohesive gameplay flow for players with different gaming interests. Last Oasis combines a global player-driven economy and an innovative vehicle system as well as complex combat and war mechanics, all working at a MMO scale. The developer wants to catch arising issues early and develop the experience alongside the community. So basically guys, this game is pretty massive. It's kind of set up similar to the way Atlas is, with the way the servers, each map being its own server. But it's kind of special. This is all in control of the developers. It's an MMO. I don't want to say RPG. There are some quests that it starts you out with. I don't know how far they continue on. I reached pretty close to level 30. I think I was like 20 something by the end of my 4 hours that I streamed it on Twitch. It's a massive, massive system, and each map is pretty darn huge. I mean, the scale is pretty big. So it is a PvP based game. Like Rust or DayZ or, Ark or whatever, there is PvP elements and there is no way to avoid that. So far during my experience, though, this can be flavored by the fact that only content creators are allowed to play at this exact moment. I didn't run into any PvP at all. I scarcely ran into another player, to be honest. I think I ran into one other player during my session. The vehicle system is really interesting. Making these huge, small to huge, gigantic walking desert ships is really cool, and you can upgrade them and do all kinds of stuff with them. They say that they have balanced the game to try and not make it so grindy. As I started building, the second walker that you are guided to make, it became apparent to me that it was really grindy. I mean, at least it felt like it to me. If I was working with another player, it probably would not have been nearly as tedious. But there was so many resources that I had to gather. I mean, I probably destroyed half of the map that I was on. stone and fiber. Man, fiber. If I give you any tip, hoard fiber when you start the game, because you will definitely need a ton of it when you start working on your second level walker. The combat mechanics in the game, at least the on foot combat mechanics, because there is combat involved with the walkers too. You can make different weapons and such for them. I did not experience that myself yet. On ground combat's really interesting. It's unique. So you move your mouse in a direction while holding your right or left button down, which kind of dictates if you're blocking or attacking. But you move your mouse in a certain direction, that dictates which way you are attacking. Like if you move your mouse up while you're holding your attack button, it's an overhand strike. If you move to the right, so forth and so on. And same thing for blocking. So it is possible to block and counter. It took me a little bit of getting used to be fair. From what I understand, it is very similar to games like Mordu or Mountain Blade, which I have no experience playing any of those. But it was really interesting, and after I got the hang of it, it was really, really fun. I think the game has a ton of potential, and it is going to be very interesting to see how it is received by the community and how the community deals with the game. Not being a PvP-oriented player myself, I it kind of, for me, on whether I actually play the game after launch, it kind of depends on which way the community goes. If the community ends up being very, very toxic, then I'm not going to be interested. You know, the community is, you know, pretty chill, you know, then I'm totally going to be down with it. I'm probably going to try it. I'm going to stick around after launch on Thursday. I'm going to play for a few days at the very least and check it out some more. But right now, this game, it looks and it feels so fun. The maps are huge. There's a lot of exploration. It has a pretty pretty decent tech tree to unlock things. You can advance your character with points, which I kept forgetting to do. So during half of the thing, I was running around with like 1 point into health. And yeah, that was kind of brutal, not gonna lie. I actually only died twice, so I felt pretty good about that, because earlier I logged on early today and I saw Syntac and Jim Bob and Axe were playing on the same server completely at random that I was on, and they were dying left, right, center. it was fun to watch. I wish I'd been recording it just to see all these chat messages popping by. The Jim Bob got killed by so and so, Axe got killed by so and so, and it was all NPCs that were killing them. Anyway, tangent. It was just funny that I logged on the server, but the game itself is pretty good. I would say keep an eye on it. If you're like me and you're not really a PvP focused person, it might not be for you, but there is a lot to this game. The possibility of trade and economy, the building of these giant walkers, which are like your mobile bases. And by the way, when you log out, you do a safe log out, so nobody can actually mess with your stuff while you're offline. So that's a really good thing too. And it seems like these walkers are going to be rather hard to destroy, because they're just really, really tough. Though that being said, I did a pretty good job of apparently weakening the legs on my first walker to the point of one of them breaking without me realizing it. So that was a thing. But yeah, it's kind of, if as a single player, as a lone player, I should say, it does feel kind of grindy trying to get all the resources together for what you need. The game itself doesn't give you much in the way of hand holding. There's a little story that pops up every time you complete one, and you hear, you know, a narration kind of giving you a little bit of lore and telling you a little bit of what you should do. But as beyond that, there's really nothing else. I feel like maybe that could be worked on just a little bit, just a tad, just a smidge. But overall, right now, for an early access game, this feels like it's going to be a very, very solid launch. It depends on how well it's received and how their servers hold up on launch day, to be honest. But I would definitely give it a look. It is available on Steam. Again, that will be on Thursday, the 26th of March. And for a limited time, they are knocking a few bucks off with this whole coronavirus thing going on to help kind of promote social distancing. So you can get it for a little bit cheaper than what it normally is. Normal retail price, I believe, is going to be right around $30 USD, and the special promotional price is going to be $25. So yeah, $5 off, not bad. But yeah, I'm going to leave you guys with some footage. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. Let me know in the comments if you've been following this game and what you think about it. But so far it looks pretty solid. It's pretty fun, and I will be streaming it more, so make sure you follow me over on twitch.tv/NeoCryptor. You know, turn those notifications on so you know when I go live. Anyway, guys, that's going to be it for this. And yeah, there might be some leftover footage at the end of this, at the end of this rant. So enjoy, and I will see you next time. Till then, this is Neo, and I'll see you in game. Bye. Jaggertooth Maul. That does 52, and that also only costs 10, but we need rope. Don't know how to get that quite yet. Repair hammer, handy. Sickle, yield, harvest small plants, okay. Pickaxe. That's 10, we have 14 left. All right, let's look other places. Purified water, yeah, we already know that. How do I unlock you? Roof skills requires woodworking station. Because this is kind of a key element right there. It looks like we need it for about everything. One. Perfect. Okay, what does it take to make this? We might actually. I think we can make this. Oh, and it's daylight. Can we make this and can we put it on our thing? Crafting. So we need 228 fiber. We need more fibre. Do I have any on here? I don't think I did. Did I? All right. Let's drop our wood up there. Let's drop this up there because we're gonna need it. Playing a hide. We need a lot of fibre right now. Let's put those in there too. All right. So off to find the fibre, I think. Actually, there's a little bit, just a little bit over here. And we can always try and beat up a Rupu to get one of those wooden shafts. We need a couple of those. We need one for our mighty hatchet of immense power. And then, of course, we need one for our new jagged club of doom, which will be nice to make. Pretty. Maybe I can start one-shotting the little whatever. The ape guys. The monkey men. Whatever they're called. Peru? Ape? Aperu? I don't know. Whatever. The you know. The guys that are in the, you know, the guys that are here. Hey, guys. What are you doing? The Rupu. At least these guys don't do a squat for damage. Oh, I say that. They do actually kind of sting a little bit, don't they? Come on, man. Oh, he's got an axe. He has got an axe. Oh, man. He's on it. He's on it. We're running. We are running away. Yeah, he does block. The NPCs are actually pretty good. Thank you.